In order to understand what sophisticated primitivism means in art, it would be good to understand something about what primitive art is. If we go online and search for primitive art, we find, what does primitive mean in art? Under this, it says primitivism in art involves the appreciation and imitation of cultural products and practices perceived to be primitive or at an earlier stage of a supposed common scale of human development. Exploring further, we find, what is naive or primitive art? And it says, before the 20th century, in its most basic sense, naive art was any form of visual art created by a person who lacked the formal education and training a professional artist undergoes. When a trained artist emulates this aesthetic, it is often referred to as primitivism, pseudo-naive art, or faux-naive art. Looking further, we can see what is the opposite of primitive art. And we find the antonyms of the word primitive are advanced, developed, evolved, high, higher, late, or sophisticated. So in this investigation of sophisticated primitivism, we'll confine our interest to painting and not get into sculpture, craft, or any of the other arts. And so to summarize what we learned from exploring online, we can say that primitive art, primitive painting, is done by individuals who haven't been trained in academies or art schools, with the knowledge and skills handed down through centuries of mainstream art evolution. On the other hand, sophisticated primitivism is art that's done by artists who have been educated about the skills of art handed down over the centuries. The skills that have accrued over time that no person without this training can have. Of course, two-dimensional art, that is, painting, has been made in all countries of the world since prehistoric time. Numerous approaches, from decorative art to figurative art, can be found in countries all across the globe. And at one point, most of these approaches were considered primitive, but this way of classifying painting is no longer the case and is considered to have come from an overly Eurocentric mindset. And each cultural art tradition is now considered to have its own impetus and viewpoint and is no longer thought to be primitive. Nowadays, if we look at primitive art as defined by naive art, that is, by artists untrained in the styles, techniques, and concepts of mainstream art, one of the first artists that comes to most people's mind is Anna Marie Robertson, better known as Grandma Moses. Of course, Grandma Moses' paintings have the characteristics of an untrained artist, which is what she was, and so fulfill the classic definition of primitive art. Yet the sheer joy she put into her paintings makes her a highly treasured American artist. Another highly recognized primitive artist was Horace Pippin. Pippin, an untrained, self-taught artist, exhibits the characteristics of a primitive artist. Yet some of his paintings have the drama and love of art that make him a valuable artist. When we look at what non-primitive, that is, sophisticated art entails, how the styles, techniques, and concepts are used in sophisticated art, we find three main ideas at least. The idea of composition, the idea of orchestration, and the idea of drawing. As handed down in mainstream art, through academies and schools, the idea of composition means the organization of shapes in the painting. With representational work, this means to take objects from the outside world and turn them into shapes and then organize those shapes in the flat space of the canvas. This is generally done to create an order of reality that is more interesting, more ordered than reality itself. With abstraction or non-representational painting, composition often entails enlivening and equalizing the negative shapes and the positive shapes of the painting. The second main idea in sophisticated painting is the idea of orchestration. Orchestration has to do with arranging and organizing the formal elements of the painting. The formal elements are the elements the artist has to work with to make the painting. Things like color, shape, edges, lines, texture, and light are the main ingredients the artist can use to make the painting. The third idea, drawing, has to do with two different approaches to drawing. And these two ideas are accuracy in drawing and non-awkwardness in drawing. With representational work, the well-learned and sophisticated artist has learned how to draw accurately with respect to things like perspective and making human forms. Generally, the primitive artist hasn't learned how to draw accurately, and so their works generally feel stiff and with an air of unnaturalness. In the expressionistic, abstract, or non-representational worlds, sophisticated drawing has to do with drawing and not creating awkwardness or unwarranted stagnation of eye flow in the painting. Typically, primitive artists haven't become interested in the more expressionistic and abstract approaches, but for those that do, there's usually a lack in the control to make the paintings harmonious and natural. So essentially, these ideas, composition, orchestration, and drawing, are the things that primitive artists don't know about. The absence of a deep knowledge of these ideas is what makes the art of the primitives primitive from the Western fine art vantage point. As the modern era set in Europe in the late 1800s, early 1900s, people, and especially artists, began to react against the urbanization and industrialization they experienced. Artists began exploring other civilizations and cultures to counter the Western traditions they thought constricting. The idea of the noble savage circulated widely during this era. According to certain ideas put out by books of the time, people's thinking about primitive cultures romanticized those cultures. Primitive cultures were thought to be in closer contact with nature and understood to be superior in conduct and goodness to the modern, corrupt man. In addition, many artists who were searching for qualities and attributes that opposed the classical, rigorous academic traditions turned to primitive cultures for inspiration. One of the first artists to engage this idea of the noble savage was the French artist Paul Gauguin. Gauguin, a stockbroker turned artist, didn't attend a formal art school, yet he got an understanding of what sophisticated art was by being around Paris, by being around the cafes with other artists, by getting to know the artists like the Impressionists, by seeing their art and talking to them about their paintings and about art in general. In the last 10 years of his life, Gauguin moved to Polynesia, to Tahiti, believing that being there in the what he called primitive culture of Tahiti would satisfy his quest for a more pure, less urbanized, less modernized culture and art. Gauguin diminished the sense of light flattening his paintings and simplified his forms to where they had a slight trace of stiffness. Yet there is clearly a sophisticated understanding of art through the use of color, texture, composition, and orchestration. It would be easy to say that Gauguin was one of the first, if not the first, artist to use sophisticated primitivism. Clearly, it was an early form of sophisticated primitivism, a primitive form of primitivism, if you would. Henri Rousseau was a self-taught French artist. Rousseau claimed he had no teacher other than nature, yet he admitted that he received some advice from two established academic painters, Félix-Auguste Clément and Jean-Léon Gérôme. He learned about sophisticated painting by frequenting the cafes and learning from the other artists of Paris. Rousseau's paintings clearly had the rigidness of primitive work, yet what he lost with stiff form was made up for with sophisticated composition, powerful and sophisticated color, and stunning and well-orchestrated texture. Another artist who was influenced by primitive ideas was Pablo Picasso. He didn't use primitive and stiff forms in his paintings per se, but in his painting, Les Demoiselles d'Avignon, he introduced the idea of masks from primitive cultures. His paintings clearly had a compositional approach that created sophisticated painting, and his use of color, texture, form, and the orchestration of all the formal elements made his art sophisticated and not primitive. In addition, his introduction of primitive culture masks influenced other artists to become interested in primitive cultures. Ernst Kirchner was a Bavarian artist. He was one of the main artists of the German Expressionist group in the early 1900s. Kirchner studied architecture and art at the Royal University of Dresden. His paintings had the sense of inaccurate drawing that appears in primitive artists' work. Yet his paintings were very sophisticated in the sense of composition, color, texture, and the handling of the formal elements. Kirchner can be seen as one of the early sophisticated primitivists. Jean Dubuffet was a French artist. He studied art at the Académie Julienne in Paris. Dubuffet sought to create an art free from overly intellectual concerns. He coined the term art brut as a style that made use of a childlike quality, yet also had the sophistication of fine art. Red Grooms was an American artist. He studied at the Art Institute of Chicago. He tended to work in a three-dimensional mode, sometimes sculptural in the round, sometimes as paintings in relief. His work had that slight stiffness that appears in primitive work, and yet clearly he handled the formal elements in a very sophisticated way. Thank you. Joan Brown was an American artist in the late 1900s who typified the idea of a sophisticated primitivist. She studied at the California School of Fine Arts. Her work is typical of the modern approach to sophisticated primitivism. A flattened picture plane, sophisticated composition and texture, and slightly awkward form. Sarah McEnany was an American artist. She was born in Munich, West Germany. Like Joan Brown, her work is clearly an approach that encompasses sophisticated primitivism. She studied at the Pennsylvania Academy of the Fine Arts in Philadelphia. Her paintings are very often autobiographical and show her and aspects of her life. So I think we can say that sophisticated primitivism is a widely used approach to art, particularly in the modern era, in the 1900s and onward. Perhaps the easiest way to describe it seems to be a slight awkwardness that equates to the awkwardness in primitive art. Yet sophisticated primitivism encompasses much more than primitive art. It includes good composition, good use of formal elements, but allows inaccurate and slightly awkward drawing done for the sake of expressionism.